Hi there, and welcome to this week's court report. I'm Keith Schweigert. He's the equally cold-ridden John Walk, and we're talking about the District 3 boys basketball playoffs, which get underway in earnest this week. John, districts technically began last Friday. We had a couple of preliminary play-in games in the higher classes, but there are first-round games in all four classes, and they're set for Tuesday and Wednesday. All in all, we have 12 LL League teams competing. How do you see the first round games shaking out?
And tentatively scheduled for Tuesday for the AAA games. We don't know what'll happen with the snow. There's a chance maybe they get all pushed back and we'll have a big Wednesday night. So stay tuned to LancasterOnline.com for that. We'll try to keep you up to date with any postponements that may or may not happen. With that being said, let's try to rapid fire through all these. I'll start with Quad A. Hemphill and Cedar Crest, these two teams split their regular season matchups, but Hemphill's going to come into this not having played in 2 weeks, and Cedar Crest, we all saw what they did in the LL League tournament. They're going to be hot, so I'm going to take the Falcons there. McCaskey and CV, we got to remember that was a close game in the LL semifinals, and CV played perhaps its best game of the year against McCaskey. The only thing that came up short is because McCaskey shot so hot from beyond the arc, so it'll be worth keeping in mind to see if McCaskey is able to repeat that performance, because if not, CV could very well pull the upset. But then again, I don't know if CV can play as well as they did in the semifinals. Lebanon Harrisburg, I would take Harrisburg, and it won't be close. AAA, Lancaster Catholic, Milton Hershey. Milton Hershey is the Mid-Penn Conference champion. I think they've only lost two times all year, so take Milton Hershey in a blowout. Mannheim Central McDevitt, the Barons probably will see their season come to an end. Cocalico and Wyo Missing, I like Cocalico advancing to this one. And Lampeter Strasburg Dover, LS definitely going to rebound from that upset loss in LL quarterfinals to Cedar Crest. They didn't come all this way to have a great season, great regular season, then fall in the playoffs. I see them rebounding easy with the win over Dover. And lastly, Elko Steel High in AAA. Elko, again, like LS, Elko's a team that had a great regular season, and they went into McCaskey in the LL quarterfinals, and they got blown out. Coach Connor said afterwards that they didn't think they handled the stage all that well, and you know, they didn't come into this season to, you know, put together such a great regular season and then fall short in the playoffs. But, you know, McCaskey and Steel High, those are two very similar teams. Wow. Steel High not as good as last year, even though Steel High is the defending District 3 AAA champion. So that'll be probably a really close game, a fun game. It'll be interesting to see if Elko can bounce back there. Lastly, in AA, Newport and Columbia, I don't think this game will matter much because the whoever comes out the winner will likely lose to Camp Hill the next round. Lancaster Mennonite, York Catholic on Friday. That's interesting to note only because Lancaster Mennonite would have been in the LL final had it hit one of those two three-pointers in the final 10 seconds against Cedar Crest in the LL semifinals. But that didn't happen. But granted, Lancaster Mennonite's playing really well in the playoffs so far. And Lancaster Mennonite went to York Catholic a few weeks ago when York Catholic came out with a 10-point win. But Coach Groff said last week that he likes his team in second time meeting York Catholic.
Yeah, they could be a tough out. It'll be interesting to see how things happen here. Out of the teams that you just talked about among our LLE contenders, any of them you see maybe making a run and going deep into districts?
Well, in Class AA, we have Lancaster Mennonite. I like them reaching the district semifinals but not getting beyond there. Class AAA, if Elko gets past Steel High, I don't see them having trouble getting to the district semis. And Lampeter Strasburg, 21-2. I think they're really going to be upset after losing the LL quarterfinals, and they're on a mission. They're in a very favorable bottom half of the bracket in the District 3 AAA tournament. I like LS making it the whole way to the title game there. And then Class Quad A, Hemphill and Cedar Crest play each other. McCaskey and CV play each other, both in the first round. So right there is two teams that are going to be gone out of the gate. And whoever wins that Hemfield-Cedar Crest game will likely have to contend with Central York in the next round. That's the top seed, Central York, the York Adams League runner-up. So I don't see anybody getting beyond Central York. And then McCaskey and CV, whoever wins that game will most likely have to play Spring Grove in the next round. Spring Grove just won the York Adams League title for the first time in 45 years. They have a Division I player in Eli Brooks. They brought back just about everybody from last year's team. They're on a tear this year. And even if McCaskey were to beat CV and get past Spring Grove, they would likely go up in the District 3 Quad A semifinals against Central York. We already talked about them. And even if McCaskey still manages to get past the quarterfinals and semifinals. Most likely, Redding's going to run away with this district title. We all know who Lonnie Walker is at this point. If you don't, just Google him or go on YouTube, and you'll see why Redding is the favorite there.
Absolutely. Wow. Well, we'll see how it's all going to play out. Thank you, John. And if you want more news and updates from the district playoffs, be sure to follow John Walk and the rest of the LMP sports staff on Facebook and on Twitter. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.